Let us solve some numericals based on this gross calorific value. One example I have given here, 0.75 grams of coal sample containing 90% carbon, hydrogen 5% and ash 5% was subjected to combustion in bomb calorimeter. Mass of water taken in the calorimeter was 2.5 kg and the water equivalent of the calorimeter 0.65 kg. The rise in temperature was found to be 3.2 degrees Celsius. Calculate gross and net calorific values of the sample. Now the given data, latent heat of steam is this much, specific heat of water is this much. Now please list the values given. W1, that is mass of water taken in the calorimeter, water equivalent of calorimeter, that is 0.65 kg, and delta T, rise in temperature. M is nothing but mass of chemical fuel. Now everything is in SI unit, so this we have to convert it into SI unit, so multiply it by 10 to the power minus 3. Then percentage of hydrogen is 5. Here carbon and ash percentage they have given, it's not required, only hydrogen percentage is required, so that is 5. Now substitute all the data in the formula, that is GCV. Always you have to write the formula first, then give the substitution. Okay, so you'll get GCV. NCV will be calculated from GCV, that is GCV minus 0.09 into percentage of hydrogen into latent heat of steam. Latent heat of steam is given, or else you can multiply it like this. Latent heat of steam in the SI unit, it is 2457. So you'll get this value. Similarly, I've given here one more numerical problem. So it's very similar to that. The temperature, whether it is given in degree Celsius or Kelvin, the difference is the same. So don't convert it into Kelvin scale. But all the units should be in SI unit, and don't forget to write the unit in the final answer. So here I've given some numericals. Please try to solve all these numericals and submit it in the Google Classroom. Hard copy or to submit it while coming to the college. Next is knocking, or it is also called as pinking. What is knocking? Knocking is the rattling sound produced in an internal combustion engine due to explosive combustion of petrol or air mixture. In how it will be generated, what happens usually? In internal combustion engine, a mixture of gasoline and air is used as fuel in all internal combustion engines. Now, after the initiation of combustion reaction by a spark in the cylinder, the flame should spread rapidly and smoothly, okay, through the gaseous mixture. Then it will expanding gas, thereby expanding the gas which drives the piston down the cylinder. Now, if the fuel air mixture undergoes sudden explosive combustion, okay, if it is not going smoothly, or if it undergoes sudden explosive combustion, a shock wave is produced and it dissipates its energy by hitting the cylinder wall and also the piston, resulting in the emitting of characteristic rattling noise, that is called as knocking. So because of explosive combustion, knocking sound appears. Now, what happens? What are the adverse effects of knocking? It produces undesirable rattling noise. It increases the fuel consumption. It results in decreased power output. It causes chemical damage due to overheating of engine parts such as spark plug, piston, engine valves. The driving becomes rather unpleasant. This is the compression ratio. Okay. It's not required. Now, what is octane number? The percentage of isooctane in a mixture of isooctane and n-heptane blend, which has the same knocking characteristic as that of the gasoline sample under test. The percentage of isooctane in a mixture of isooctane and heptane blend, which has the same knocking characteristic as that of the gasoline sample under test. Okay, so here octane number, alkanes have very low anti-knocking characteristic. Very low anti-knocking characteristic or low octane number. And this octane number, please reverse this sign. Okay, please reverse this sign. For octane number is least for alkanes and it's highest for aromatics. This is structure of isooctane n-heptane. Now, mechanism of knocking, it's very important, this mechanism of knocking. So here I've taken one simple example to explain this knocking process. So in normal combustion process, what happens, this chemical fuel, it combines with the oxygen and it produces activated hydrocarbon molecules, and this activated hydrocarbon molecules, it reacts with one more molecule of hydrocarbon and it produces at another activated hydrocarbon. So like this chain reaction occurs. But in the case of explosive combustion, hydrocarbon molecules react with the oxygen and it produces unstable peroxides, and this will decompose explosively and it produces lot of byproducts, gaseous products. So there will be a lot of pressure developed. So due to this, that will create knocking sound. So here ethane molecule has been taken. See, during knocking process, see, ethane peroxide will be formed. This ethane peroxide is highly unstable. It will undergo decomposition and it produces acetaldehyde and water. Again, this acetaldehyde, it reacts with oxygen and it produces formaldehyde and carbon dioxide plus water, and formaldehyde again it reacts with oxygen and it gives water and carbon dioxide. If you add all these products, you get this particular reaction. So this is what happens in the case of explosive combustion, that is mainly due to the production of peroxides. How do we prevent knocking? Prevention of knocking, that we will see in the next video.